Dear students, assalamu alaikum. I hope you would be safe and sound inside your homes. The pandemic pressure is still heavy here. It has badly trapped the world. So far, more than 10 lakh people died worldwide. And in India, its infection is also increasing at alarming pace. And J&K is never an exception because it has reached to every nook and corner of the world. In these days of pandemic, we need to be extra cautious and extra careful to save our lives first, and then we should give the preference to the things that are related to the life. Dear students, from 21st of September 2020, the physical mode of teaching has started partially. Better is to attend school on your term with all SOPs to be followed in letter and spirit so that you can save your lives from this deadly virus and also can fetch something good from the physical mode of teaching. Dear students, this virtual world is also going so smoothly. You should get yourselves benefited from both the modes, that is the physical mode as well as the virtual mode. Because your examinations are approaching fast, they are being held in the month of November, and you need to put extra efforts. You have to do extra hard work so that you can cross the examination very easily. No doubt the institutions or the schools remained shut for very long duration of a time, and you were hit badly academically. Your academic loss was at the peak. Better is to concentrate on self-studies and attend schools, take guidance from your teachers to crack the examinations that are scheduled in the month of November. And you need to be psychologically motivated that you will cross the examination with ease. Dear students of class 11th, subject political science, today we are dealing with one more important topic in your political science, that is the role and position of the Indian Prime Minister. Dear students, Prime Minister of India must have the qualifications first. He or she should be the citizen of India. He should be the 25 years of the age in case of he is the member of Lok Sabha, and 30 years of age in case he is a member of the Rajya Sabha. He should not be convicted or a criminal, and he should be the member of either house of the parliament, whether it is Lok Sabha or Rajya Sabha, but he should belong to the party that has majority in the Lok Sabha. First of all, you need how he is appointed. When general elections take place for Lok Sabha after term the 5 years, the party that gains the majority, choose their head, and the head of that very party becomes Prime Minister. And Prime Minister is appointed by the President of India. Remember, the party in Lok Sabha election that gains the majority, choose their head, and head of that very party becomes Prime Minister. And Prime Minister of India is appointed by the President of the India. And Article 74 of the Indian Constitution says that there should be a Prime Minister who will aid the President of India in running the government affairs. Remember, there is a double set of executive. One is the ceremonial or nominal executive, that is the President being the head of the state, and the Prime Minister is the head of the government. All the powers are given in the name of President, but in real they are exercised by the Prime Minister of India. So we have to keep in the mind that the party that gains the majority choose their head, and head of that very party becomes Prime Minister, and Prime Minister of India is appointed by the President of India. On the advice of the Prime Minister, the rest of the Council of Ministers is appointed. And when the Prime Minister of India is appointed, he gives names to the President of India for his cabinet, and on the advice of the Prime Minister, rest of the Council of Ministers is formed. So here the role of the Prime Minister starts. He allocates portfolios to different ministers. He can drop a minister and he can change the portfolio of a minister. Well, dear students, remember, all the powers are given in the name of President, but in real they are exercised by the Prime Minister of India. He is the head of the Union Cabinet, and he is the senior most member of the entire cabinet. Dear students, the Prime Minister is actually the real head. No doubt the President is there. He is the first citizen. He is the head of the state. But the head of the government is the Prime Minister of India. And the Prime Minister in a real runs the administration of the whole state. He supervises the work of the ministers. He coordinates the work of the ministers by through cabinet secretaries. Well, he's head of the cabinet. He presides all the cabinet meetings. His decisions in cabinet are final. He attends the Lok Sabha as well as the Raj Sabha on a particular session to answer the queries raised by the parliament members or sometimes the change of portfolios of the ministers. So dear students, the Prime Minister of India has a very important role. Remember, the Prime Minister of India should belong to the party that has majority in the Lok Sabha, and all the decisions are carried in the cabinet in the name of president, but these decisions are actually taken by the unit cabinet headed by the Prime Minister of India. Dear students, internationally, he is the important, he is the head of the government. All the international meetings or all the international delegations, for example, if heads of the governments are invited for at any international forum, the Prime Minister has to attend that very much. His role is important there. He decides the things there. He signs the treaties there. So his role is very important. He serves the bridge between the Union Cabinet and the President. So the Prime Minister of India is the real head. He is blessed with the huge powers. He is blessed. No doubt the Union Cabinet is responsible, accountable before the Lok Sabha, but he is blessed with the huge powers. He is the reservoir of the powers. Dear students, all the highest posts in India are appointed by the President of India, but he has to seek the recommendations from the Prime Minister of India. For example, when the Chief Election Commissioner of India and other election commissioners are appointed by the President of India, he has to seek the recommendations from the Prime Minister of India. Comptroller and Auditor General of India is appointed by the President of India, but on the advice of the Prime Minister of India. Simply, Chairperson of the Finance Commission and other members are appointed by the President of India, but he has to seek their advice from the Prime Minister of India. So the Prime Minister of India has a very important role in the cabinet. It is the Prime Minister of the India that runs actually the whole state. No doubt, the President is there, he is the head of the state, but on the advice of the Prime Minister, everything is carried on by the President of India. Dear students, so the role of the Prime Minister is important. He heads the cabinet, the council of ministers, that is the executive branch of the government. This is the all the cabinet decisions are taken in the unit cabinet, and these decisions are carried in the name of president, but these decisions are taken finally by the Prime Minister of India because he heads the union cabinet. He serves bridge between the president and the union cabinet. He allocates portfolios to different ministers. He can even drop a minister. He can even change the portfolio of a minister. He coordinates the work of the ministers. He supervises the work of ministers. If he sometimes remains unsatisfied with the work of the minister, he drops them or he changes portfolio. So his role is very important in India. So Prime Minister is the real head of the government. He is blessed with huge powers. This is enough for today. And better is to see these things on your available political science books. If any sort of confusion or query strikes your mind after watching this video, you can call me on my number that's already in your position. And when you call or WhatsApp me, if you have any type of query, and within short duration of time, your query shall be answered. Better is to concentrate on self-studies and remain psychologically motivated to crack every barrier. Thanks. Be well, asset.